Well, here's a look at where Santa Claus is now on his gift-giving journey. According to the North American Aerospace Defense Command, or NORAD, Saint Nick and his reindeer sled are on their way to Panama to deliver presents. So far, they've delivered around 6 million gifts across the world. NORAD's tradition of tracking Santa's journey began in 1955. When a child, accidentally dialed the Continental Air Defense Command Operations Center in Colorado, believing she was calling Santa Claus after seeing a promotion in a local newspaper. Here's a look now at how other countries are celebrating the holidays. In Florida's Cocoa Beach, dozens of surfing Santas and a few elves took to the waves on Christmas Eve for the annual Surfing Santa Day. The event, now on its 15th year, includes live music and a costume contest. The beach is also the place to be in Odisha, India, where an artist unveiled a sand art featuring a 100-foot-long reclining Santa. It also incorporated 2,000 kilos of onion. The artist says the inspiration behind the creation was climate change. And in Russia, hundreds of cars formed a giant Christmas tree in the Siberian city of Krasnoyarsk. Russia's Book of Records says over 800 cars were used to create the tree shape, setting a new record for the country. Over at the Vatican, those suffering from wars remembered by Pope Francis during his Angelus prayer on Christmas Eve. The pontiff urged the faithful to think of Palestine, Israel, and Ukraine. He told the faithful not to confuse celebration with consumerism. Instead, he called on them to share with those who lack necessities or companionship. Later that evening, Pope Francis spoke on the conflict in the Holy Land during his homily at the St. Peter's Basilica. He lamented that Jesus' message of peace was being drowned out by the futile logic of war in the very land where he was born. Let's now look at Christmas messages from Filipino officials, starting with President Marcos himself. He urged the public to spread hope and reach out to the needy. This, as he believes the true meaning of Christmas is lending a hand to those who are suffering from solitude, sickness, and poverty.
Buksan po natin ang ating mga puso at ang mga tahanan upang maipadama natin ang pagmamahal at saya sa ating mga kababayan, lalong-lalo na sa lubos na nangangailangan. Naway isabuhay din natin ang tunay ng diwa ng Pasko sa pamamagitan ng pag-unawa, pagkalinga at pagtulong sa kapwa. Sa pamamagitan nito, tayo ay nagsisilbing parol ng siyang nagbibigay ng sigla, kulay at liwanag sa buhay ng bawat isa tungo sa mas maunlad na bagong Pilipinas.
Marcos's call was echoed by Vice President Sara Duterte.
Huwag nating kalimutan sa Pasko at sa abot ng ating makakaya sa iba pang mga araw ay tulungan at damayan natin ang ating mga kapwa Pilipino na naghihirap, nagugutom, may karamdaman at nag-aagaw buhay.
Meanwhile, Senate President Mig Zubiri simply urged the public to express gratitude for the blessings they received throughout the year and to celebrate their achievements. And finally, House Speaker Martin Romualdez reminded Filipinos that the best gift they can have is the presence of their loved ones. Public parks in Metro Manila are jam-packed with Filipino families who celebrated Christmas Eve on Sunday night at Luneta Park. Christmas lights and decorations spread delight to onlookers. Some also chose to spend Christmas Eve by attending evening masses and completing the so-called Simbang Gabi. The churchgoers were urged to still attend masses even after the Yuletide season.
Magsimba kayo dahil gusto ninyong magpasalamat. Magpasalamat sa mga biyayang patuloy nating tinatanggap mula sa kabutihan ng Diyos.
Many Filipino families are now out and about on Christmas Day. Some of them are spending quality time at the Quezon Memorial Circle in Quezon City. Now, Jervis Manan joins us live from there. Jervis, what's happening?
Yes, sadly, quite a lot of families went to the Quezon Memorial Circle to spend Christmas Day there. They brought food and toys to have fun inside the park. There were a lot of children playing in several attractions inside the circle. Admission is free and the park is open until late night to accommodate those who would want to spend Christmas there. Some families even came from nearby cities. Visitors traditionally flock the park during the holiday season. Right now, Sandy, we are at the Manila Zoo where there are thousands of families also celebrating Christmas. Some said they have traveled all the way from far provinces just to spend Christmas here. Later today, we'll be heading at the Rizal Park where there is a lot of Filipinos expected. So far, we have seen very peaceful situation, very joyous and festive mood in all the parks that we have visited this Christmas Day. Sandy.
All right. Thank you so much for that Christmas update, Jervis Manahan. Let's now check on the situation at the Quiapo Church where the Catholic faithful are attending hourly masses. Robert Mano joins us on the line from Quiapo. Go ahead, Robert.
Stanley, families continue to arrive in various churches in National Capital Region to attend Christmas Day Mass. At Santo Domingo Church in Quezon City, family attend the Holy Mass together. After the Mass, they take the opportunity to capture images at the church's nativity scene. Others opted to take pictures outside the church near a giant Christmas tree. In Quiapo Church, churchgoers extend beyond the church premises. There's a large wall outside the church allowing them to witness the Mass. Some disregard the blazing heat of the sun using umbrellas just to attend the Mass. Among them is the Soriano family from Pasig City. According to Ricky Soriano, they started the Christmas celebration by attending the Mass and wish for good health of his entire family, and they will proceed to Luneta Park. As early as 5 in the morning, Quiapo Church is already packed with parishioners. Masses are conducted every hour, totaling 13 Masses in the Basilica of the Black Nazarene until 7 p.m. later. Stanley.
All right. Thank you so much for the update from Quiapo. Robert Mano, Merry Christmas to you as well. Now, Disney is spreading the holiday magic to Filipinos with its Disney on Ice show at Mall of Asia in Pasay City. Let's check it out. Vivian Gulia joins us from there right now. Viv, how exciting is this?
Stanley, well, they say Christmas is for kids and for the family, and that is what we're seeing here at the Mall of Asia Arena in Pasay City as parents and even grandparents bring their children and grandchildren to see the return of the Disney on Ice show after 3 years. As you can see, several children are wearing their costume of their favorite Disney princess, looking all excited, while many adults are seen wearing Disney cartoon character headbands. One of the moms that we interviewed earlier, Camille Carcosia, said that the show would be a good bonding moment for her and her five-year-old kid, and she thought that her daughter would appreciate this as a gift. The show features characters like Mickey and Minnie Mouse, Donald and Daisy Duck, Elsa and Anna, Princess Jasmine and Aladdin, Moana, Mary Poppins, skating as they sing popular songs in the movies. There are also aerial acrobats and cyclists, complemented by colorful digital backgrounds that make the show more entertaining, exciting, and magical. Lucky audiences on the front row may also get the chance to interact with the characters. SM Moa Arena General Manager Arnel Gonzalez said Christmas Day is one of their peak days for the show, and the turnout this year has already exceeded pre-pandemic levels. Some families spending Christmas here are staying to see the sparkling lights and immersive attractions in the mall compound later. There will also be fireworks display at 7 p.m. to cap the sightseeing and bonding moments this Christmas. Stanley, back to you.
All right, Viv, do enjoy the show and Merry Christmas to you. A bleak Christmas for dozens of passengers who remain stranded at the Manila North Port. This after trips were canceled on Christmas Eve due to unfavorable weather conditions. According to passengers, the next trips have been scheduled tomorrow, December 26. The Philippine Ports Authority says the shipping line is mandated to provide assistance to travelers.
Primarily po, yan po ay obligasyon po nung shipping line.
Barko, okay.
Pero tayo po sa PPA, alam nyo naman po, sa mga pagkakataon po tayo nagbibigay na din po ng tubig at lugaw ano so kung para mapunan yung pagkukulang po ng mga shipping line. Normally po hindi po ba may sa departure area lang po yung mga tao bago
yes.
sumakay.
Yes.
Pero ngayon po pinabuksan ko po yung arrival area na air condition din nakapagbata po ang kasama or yung pong senior or may mga special needs po doon po sila pahihintayin.
Several parts of the Philippines expected to have a rainy Christmas Day as the northeast monsoon and shear line continue to affect the country. State Weather Bureau Pagasa says the northeast monsoon will surge through today, Monday, and is expected to weaken by Wednesday, while the shear line will affect the Philippines until Thursday. Among the areas slated to experience rains today are Eastern Cordillera, Cagayan Valley, Aurora, Quezon, Oriental Mindoro, as well as parts of Bicol. Nutrition specialist Christine Jane Atienza becomes the first Filipino analog astronaut. Izzy Lee tells us about Atienza's Martian experience.
What does it feel like to leave the Martian life? 31-year-old Christine Jane Atienza shares this experience after joining an analog mission with the Hawaii Space Exploration Analog and Simulation or High Seas in November on the slopes of Mauna Loa Volcano.
Yung sinisimulate niya, it's yung Mars. So if ever magkaroon tayo ng first habitat sa Mars, saan pwede sa Mars pumunta, anong like geological features yung pwedeng puntahan and ano yung mga, kung paano yung procedures ng expedition, geological expedition sa Mars.
Analog missions are field tests done in locations that replicate extreme space environments. These missions provide a controlled environment for testing equipment, conducting experiments, and evaluating the physical and psychological effects of extended space missions. While not actual space flights, analog missions help prepare astronauts and researchers for the challenges they might encounter in space. Contrary to the traditional astronaut profile dominated by scientists and engineers, Atienza, armed with her background in community nutrition from the University of the Philippines Diliman, found her calling in space exploration.
Ever since I'm a kid, I really wanted to become an astronomer, not actually an astronaut. So, naging active ako sa astronomy community, space community. Last year, parang naisip ko na, what if mag-apply ako as a crew? Kasi my goal was to make my study better for space nutrition.
Atienza's mission, which spanned 6 days in an isolated dome named Habitat, cast her in the roles of a nutrition specialist and medical officer.
Ako yung nag-check na inventory ng food namin, kung kasha pa ba for our whole mission, kasi limited lang yung resources. Most of the time, I oversee the preparation and the caloric content. As medical officer, every morning, I just check their vital signs and if they have like problems, kung nagka-wound ba sila during lava tube mission. So, I check those and I give medicine.
Atienza highlights that the greatest challenge lies in isolation, which tested their interpersonal and psychological well-being. Disconnected from social media, the crew communicated through email, mimicking the communication delay between Earth and Mars and fostering resilience and adaptability. Atienza also acknowledged their struggles, from the scarcity of water preventing daily showers to the confined living spaces, exemplifying the difficulties posed by space exploration. She believes her mission not only broke barriers, but also sparked inspiration for others who dream of finding their place in space.
As a Filipino, it's kind of hard to dream to go to space kasi back then we didn't have that resources or opportunities. Pero ngayon, it's opening up. So hopefully I sparked imagination and hopes of Filipinos again for space.
Atienza's message is clear. Space is inclusive and regardless of background or profession, there is a place for everyone in the cosmos. Easily, ABS-CBN News.